The most important feature of a transparent bridge is its source address table, or SAT. The SAT is the bridge's database where it keeps track of all network devices. Remember we said that a bridge learns where devices are located and then forwards packets based on this information? This whole process is possible because the bridge examines every packet that it sees and uses the information to update its SAT. Let's take a look at how this works. When a packet is received at a bridge port, the bridge examines the packet to determine where it should be sent. The bridge looks not only at where the packet is going, but also at where it came from. This is accomplished by examining the source address of the packet. And remember, in this case, the source address is the MAC address. If a bridge sees a packet that originated from device D and that packet was received on port 2, the bridge records that device D is located on port 2. This information is then added to the bridge's source address table. Now you can see where the name source address table comes from. The table is built by looking at source addresses. When information is added into the source address table, it's normally retained for 5 minutes. The duration of 5 minutes is a default value and may be changed. However, every time the bridge receives a packet from a device, it resets the 5-minute timer for that MAC address. This examination of the packets and updating of the source address table can occur thousands of times a second, depending on network activity. Now you can see why the transparent bridge is also called a learning bridge, as it learns addresses by examining incoming packets.